Hello everyone! So today I'm with Carolyn again for yet another holiday video. Today we'll be talking about
the truth about Santa.
Both of our stories of how we found out about Santa Claus are quite dramatic, yet so are every kid's. Carolyn, how did you find out about Santa Claus? Okay.
So my parents were actually very, very good. They never messed up, they never made any mistakes, they always hid the gifts in the correct place. So I never typically found out like kids usually do, where it's like, Mommy, why does Daddy look like Santa Claus? Or
why are you kissing Santa Claus?
Exactly, but no, they did a really good job. In fifth grade, one day they brought me down to the basement, and I had one younger sister at this time, but I have two now. So, and I'm 17, and my youngest sister right now is 7, so a big age difference. But at this time, when I was in fifth grade, I only had one, and one on the way. So they took me down to the basement, and they were like, Carolyn, we have something to tell you. Carolyn, Santa's not real.
Did you cry?
I'll get to that. I was like, no. And I started bawling. I was crying. I was rolling on the floor, like screaming and crying.
I can see that. You were quite dramatic.
I was really
dramatic now, but like you're more dramatic then too.
I had a meltdown, okay? And like lying was a big rule in my house. Like my parents were always like, never lie. Mm-hmm. Because I would
now
rather
you're like, why did you lie to me? Mommy!
You tell me not to lie, and then you lie to me for 11 years of my life.
Gasp, this is like a soap opera.
The biggest lie of my life. So I'm like crying, and they're like looking at each other, and like we expected this because she's dramatic. And then I was like crying, and I looked up, and I was like, does that mean the tooth fairy's not real either?
Oh my god.
And they go, yes. And I go, the Easter Bunny? And they go, and they go, the leprechaun? And they go, and I'm like,
you're like, you were all of them! You're like, you were all four? And they're like,
I'm like,
yeah.
Santa I could deal with, but the Easter Bunny and the where are you getting all of that money?
It's okay.
And then I asked for my teeth back. So I was very, very upset. And since Sarah's an only child, so she'll tell you about that, but since I'm the oldest of three, had to keep this bottled in. I'm still keeping it bottled in because I have a 7-year-old sister.
Yeah. Well, so my story is pretty similar, actually. I was laying in bed with both my parents one night, and my mom was in a really, really bad mood. A lot of my friends know my parents are super, like, attitude sassy, so that's where I got, like, my attitude from. But I was laying in bed, and I was whining, and I'm like, Mom, I was about in second grade, so it was a lot sooner than you. And I go, Mom, is there such thing as Santa Claus? And my dad's like, oh my god, don't do it. Don't do it. Don't you dare do it. And my mom goes, I'm not gonna tell you right now. And then I go, I wanna know. Tell me the truth right now. And they go, no, not right now. We
I see
don't wanna
you
tell
your
you.
Sass from Sarah.
I was a little jerk at a very young age. I go, no, I wanna know now. And my mom rolls over and she goes, you know what? There's no Santa Claus, Tooth Fairy, Leprechaun, or the Easter Bunny. And my dad just rolls over and pulls the sheets over himself and he goes, I'm not saying anything.
What did you do?
I bawled my eyes out and ran into my room, and then they both looked at each other. Apparently, they both looked at each other and were like, oh, that's not how it was supposed to happen.
Oh, and mine was way more formal.
Yeah, yours was formal. My parents didn't mean
like
to tell
talk,
me.
But like it was the talk, but like the other kind of talk.
The talk. But yeah, mine wasn't very formal at all. It was kind of an accident, so I knew at a very young age, but that's a very interesting topic you brought up about how if one person doesn't believe, then it's difficult for all the other kids.
Well, it's even difficult when they do it at different times because I was in fifth grade.
I think
still
we were all telling you by then, though.
I know, but like I just told them they were wrong. Yeah. But she was in second grade, and I was in fifth grade, and all my friends were saying, you know, Carolyn, something's up, and I'm like,
what?
My parents would never lie to me. My parents tell me lying's bad.
And now you're like, oh, well, crap. But what I was thinking about is, when I have kids, I'm gonna want to tell him about Santa Claus, but deep down inside, I'm gonna be like, why am I letting this fat old man who lives in the North Pole take credit for these presents I bought for my kids?
No, because I'd always be like, oh, Santa gets me the best presents, and why can't you get me as many presents as Santa?
Parents feel bad about themselves, thinking, wow, I just worked overtime to buy these presents for my kids, and now they think this old fat man is buying them for them.
Oh, no, eventually.
No, eventually.
And they'll thank them for all that.
Sometimes I still wish I believed in that stuff because I watch all these Hallmark movies and I go, magic! And then I'm like, no.
But the magic's in the family.
Magic is in the family and in the friends. Yay! Okay. That was a good talk. Good talk.
Oh, okay.
Good talk. All right, so give us your opinion on what you think about Santa Claus and whether or not when you get older, if you'll continue the tradition. So that's an interesting topic. All right. Thanks, guys. Bye.
Bye.